collaboration between SPTV and the Southern Maine Blues Society.
Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Blues at the Breakwater. Tonight we bring you those bad boys from Portland, Maine, the Blue Roots.
Why did you ever? Why did you ever? Why did you ever? 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 Or did you ever wake up with them bug frogs on your mind? Did you ever wake up with them bug frogs on your mind? Sit there laughing, laughing just to keep up. One. just to keep them crying. Thank you, Spring Point. Yeah, nice crowd we got here tonight, I guarantee that.
Thank you. Hey, that's one of our tunes.
Yeah, we're going to have Stevie Van Vysteen, the pride of the North Country, singing those songs right now.
Done come. You made me love you, baby, and now you're
Pride of Presque Isle, Maine, Stevie Van Vierstein. I think it's superstar Frank from Philly time. This is the newest addition to the Blue Roots. He joined the band this year, and we ain't gonna let him out.
Where the former owner died. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Button for the overdrive. Driving, looking for some.
Slow things down with the world's saddest blues song right now for y'all. Thank you. be lonesome. Too damn inconvenient to live alone. Too sad to be lonesome. Too damn inconvenient to live alone. Like a tossing ship out on a turning sea. I'm drifting and drifting. Like a tossing ship out on a turning sea. Bowling ball, my Ted Williams fly casting reel, my Pete Rose baseball bat, my Ginsu steak knives, my Civil War chess set, and my record of Nana Muscuri, Return to Romance. That's my favorite. Yeah, you took all that crap and you packed up your father's Oldsmobile and you made the right move to Lewiston Harbor. But that didn't piss me off, no sir. What you did right before you left, I'm gonna tell you about it. You should know this too. Right before you left, you did some of my laundry. You did a real nice job too. Got out the ring around the collar with the whisk. You gave me the State Puff routine. You gave me that downy freshness all the guys in the band like so much. And you got rid of that nasty static plan. You washed my shirts, you washed my pants, you washed my socks, you shampooed my chapeau even. And then you went and washed my vest. In the words of the immortal Ralph Cramden. You remember him? Ralph Cramden? In my vest pocket was a mirror, a razor blade, and 5 or 6 little paper packages. Me and the Blue Roots are gonna do that Wednesday night after we're bowling. You gotta completely soak in the wash, Alice. One of these days, Alice, to the moon, Alice, to the moon. happy home. Yeah, we're the Blue Roots. We're gonna take a short pause. We'll be right back. Stick around, because the third set is a month old.
Hi, everybody. My name is Mark Murphy, and I'm here in company with the Blue Roots, the Bad Boys from Portland. First of all, I'm going to get a chance to introduce everybody to you. We'll start out right here. Pride of Prescott, Maine, Stevie Van Vysteen. And to his left is going to be Howlin' Dog Foster from Winthrop, Maine. To Howlin' Dog's left, we have Barbecue Bob. To his left is going to be Rusty Gates and our superstar, Frank from Philly. Going to try to get an idea about how all these guys started out in the business, especially here in Portland, Maine. The core group of the band at the very beginning was Steve, Howlin' Dog, and Rusty, and they can give you a little bit of idea about how they started out getting together. Go ahead, Matt.
Well, I met Steve at a videotape session for this band that I used to be in. We needed somebody to drive a car, and here comes Steve down the road at a high rate of speed. Fit the bill perfectly, just what we needed. So they needed a bass player for this band, the Crazy Eddie and the Original Doodah Band. So of course it was totally unrehearsed. We all met on stage, met Rusty on stage. I'd met Steve off stage, but we never played together until we met on stage. And we just followed Crazy Eddie.
Now, what exactly did you guys do with Eddie?
And of course we're on television now.
Go ahead. Country comedy and fractured folk music.
Very fractured. How do you call that kind of country?
Where'd you guys play? What type of things did you play?
Oh, biker bars.
Biker bars.
Yeah, fairs. Outdoor parties a lot. Lobster bakes.
Mm-hmm. And then I think what happened next was you guys. Oh, this guy.
Barbecue Bob came wandering into the Driftwood one night.
Wandering in, yeah. I've been doing a thing on playing on street corners and sitting with various bands, and I heard these guys sound. I knew the Howlin' Dog from many years ago. We met in the back of a police cruiser in Winthrop on one unfortunate evening. We had a good time, wasn't it?
We did have a good time. They let us go in the long run, but we had to hang out.
But I didn't know I was going to be spending half the rest of my life with them at the time. You know, otherwise I would have given myself up at the point. these guys were opening up for Crazy Eddie, and they would play like a blues set before Crazy Eddie. And one club they played at, they liked the opening set better than they really liked Crazy Eddie stuff. They said, why don't you bring a blues band up? So Rusty gave me a call on the phone and said, we got this blues thing lined up. Why don't you come up with us? And we started doing this thing. We played this weekend of this thing. We probably never thought it was going to amount to anything. And then I got talking with a club owner down in Old Orchard. And the next thing I knew, we had a gig down there. And then something sprang up in Portland. We opened a Marble Bar back then. It was a little place. I'm hesitant to call it a dive. It was a reputable establishment, but, you know, you gotta start somewhere.
Everybody came down to have a good time.
We had a lot of fun with them. And we still were kind of fledgling at that point, and we went through half dozen or so bass players, and we finally ended up with Eugene Von Lederhosen, who's not here right now. He had to go home, he had a little toothache, but.
He had his head drilled out.
The last member to join permanently was old Frank from Philly. We picked him up at a Portuguese-Irish wedding we were doing at the Regency. He was doing a wedding song, and he did that with us, and we liked him so well, we kept him along.
I was kidnapped.
That's kind of how the whole six-piece got together, although it was quite a few years there. We played four-piece and five-piece from time to time, and I think it works.
Whoever showed up.
I think it works good the way it is now.
Whose
with the
60s.
Right. Whose turn is it? Yeah.
Yeah, I like that whole aspect of you guys where everybody gets a chance, and there's no prima donnas or anything like that.
No bench warmers.
No bench warmers. You got it. Everybody's got to get up front and start hollering and yelling.
Even myself.
Yeah. I've done my share of other things.
The basic premise is just to have a good time, and hopefully the audience goes along with it, and they have a good time too. That's what the whole thing is about, you know, the blues and country and rock and roll all blended into one. Honest music, bunch of honest guys.
As long as we're playing music.
All right, you guys, what do you think? You hoping everything's going to keep going for you like this in the future?
Well, we hope to cut a record deal soon and go to Amsterdam and never come back, but...
I think that sounds like a great idea. Look, thanks a lot for you guys, you know, giving us this background about yourselves, and everybody out there in TV land, see these guys, they're the hippest in town.
Hey, thanks, Murph.
Yeah.
Thanks, Murph.
How much we owe you?
Welcome back to Blues at the Breakwater for round number 3. Here they are again, the Bad Boys from Portland, Maine, the Blue Roots.
Since the last days of the Blue Roots, people like our friend Carolyn here all the time coming up and asking me, Barbecue, what's the best microphone to get that ratty blues sound out of the harp? I'll tell it just right here, darling. Don't leave home without a 1995 from Radio Shack. Same kind she used to watch on TV when her little brother, they used to make Jiffy Pop, they used to watch Adam 12. Remember this?
What Adam 12? What Adam 12? Who the rant about it, Gustavo.
That brings back memories. You blow hard through this, you're gonna bring back some more memories. You're gonna sound like Fred MacMurray on My Three Sons. Sound like Chip and Ernie upstairs dipping into Uncle Charlie's stash. My favorite little feature with this number is you can sing through it and make yourself sound like you're already dead, singing out of your own grave. Goes like this right here.
Right out of my mind. I spent a lot.
lonesome too.
We're gonna get our old buddy Murph Man up here and sing a little Muddy Waters. Let's have a hand for Murph Man.
All right, thank you. This is a song about horizontal dancing. You say that on TV.
Well, I'm bugging to your socket, man.
tied up in the daytime. Then I get a little loose at night. Let it loose all over you, baby. I light you up like a light. Man, call me Merman. Let all the young girls call me Electric Man. When I plug into your socket, baby, I'm gonna charge it like no other man.
It's about time for superstar Frank from Philly one more time here for you. This one I know you're gonna like.
And the sign is fruit. Baby, call me on the telephone. Say she wanna ball me all night long. But I wanna ball, what can I do? I got Chubuku Lucas and the sign is fruit. Stevie!
Rusty Gates, also known as Jeff Irvin, you know, he got a nice tie on tonight. Out of all the drummers in Portland, he's known to have the longest, if not the widest, necktie in Portland. Now we got Stevie Van Vosteen. He's just itching to sing his little song for you here. When I come to yearning, my whole heart starts turning up down.
Van Vosteen, and we're the Blue Roots. Thanks a lot for coming down. We had a great time tonight, and that's what it's all about. I hope you had fun, too. See you next time.